Hey y'all, so today we're going to fix a Ryobi 40 volt lawnmower that is not starting. So you know, we put in the battery, put in the key, the lights go on, but the motor won't turn. Let's break her down. To do that we need to use Torx security bits, and I just happen to have these long ones that fit down in the holes in the back. If you're taking this apart, don't forget to take off the height adjustment handle, just two Phillips screws. So looks like I forgot a couple, probably because they were full of gunk. So let's get those out too. So first we're going to test the actuator. That's a safety feature. Make sure the handle is in the right position when it's in use. If it's in the wrong place, then the circuit will be broken. So to test it, we just use a multimeter and make sure that there is no resistance when it's depressed. So the yellow line runs through that actuator and the black and red go up the handle. Funny story about this one. I'll tell you that in a bit. My multimeter said that one was working fine, so time to check the others up at the top of the handle that are prone to issues. One for the safety bar pull, and one for the button. Just trying some different combinations here. Turns out that holding the power button and then pulling the handle, holding that actuator switch, is the winning combination. So we have a motor that spins for the first time in a few years. So I think we've found our fault. Let's just double check that. We'll hook these two ends together to bypass the power button. Yep, sure enough, that's it. So that power button is just the kind that turns on when you press it once and breaks the circuit when you press it again. So let's just bypass it entirely, put these two wires together with a pigtail. We can get a replacement part, or we could just leave it like this. That's just one of several safety features. The actuator at the base of the handle to make sure it's locked in the appropriate position. The lever at the top to make sure that your hands are in the right place. And there are two actuators in the center of the handle as well to make sure that it's locked in its extended position. So it's still relatively safe. So everything seems to be working, so let's get it all back together. Of course, getting the cover back on is an enormous pain. Ryobi really doesn't make this easy. Everything has to fit just right. Maybe I had to take the wheels off or other parts off, but I just didn't have the patience.
What?
Of course, I should have had the patience because as I was forcing the top in there, I broke the handle placement safety actuator. I was able to find this part online at Parts Warehouse and ordered it, but it's going to take at least a week to get here. So I tried to fix the switch. I ended up doing it. I fabricated a couple tiny springs just using my drill, a 1/16 drill bit, and some guitar string, which is a really good spring wire, as it turns out. Just made it so that it could squeeze a little bit, and we're good to go. So got everything back together, really gently this time. We've got ourselves a working lawnmower. Thanks for watching.